I had the opportunity to meet Lee Harvey Oswald on 4 different times in New Orleans. The first time was when he tried to infiltrate the Cuban Student Directorate, that is the organization that I represent in New Orleans, Louisiana. And I believe that if he was working at that moment for the Fair Play for Cuba Committee, and he was trying to infiltrate one anti-Castro organization, it's obvious that he was working for somebody else at that moment, and that somebody else could not be anyone else than Fidel Castro.
Do you have any other claims that support your belief?
Well, the question is this. At that moment, we had one anti-Castro training camp in New Orleans, and we have proof that that training camp was infiltrated by Fidel Castro. There was a Castro spy with the name of Fernando Fernandez Barcena, who sent a letter that we intercept to the Cuban ambassador in Mexico, warning him about the training camp and asked him to be alert until August the 8th. And the day that Oswald tried to infiltrate our organization was on August the 5th. After that, when I turned down Oswald's offer, I found him in the street carrying on a rally in favor of Fidel Castro with a big sign in his chest reading Viva Fidel and Hands Off Cuba. At that moment I had a small fight with him and I went to jail with him. At the jail he was really cold blood. He was answering the question that he liked to answer in the way that he liked to answer. He was not a nut or a nervous person, nothing like that. He was an indoctrinated communist. And at the jail we found out something interesting. The name that he was using on New Orleans at that moment was the name of A.J. Heidel. That was the name that he was using in the literature from the Fair Play for Cuba Committee that he was handing out. After that, we found out after the assassination that he had been in Mexico not only one time, it had been published until this moment, he had been in Mexico several times. And I have with me in this tour one part of a speech delivered by Castro on Havana on November 27, 1963, 5 days after the assassination. And in that speech, Castro admitted that Lee Harvey Oswald had been in Cuba before.